And question number 3, from the same topic, reverse syllogism. The conclusions are given like all these being B is a possibility. So here we have a main thing, being and possibility. And conclusion 2 is some C or E. And this question actually has 5 statements and all the 5 are very very big. And this question is going to be a very important question. And you can take this like a sample question for all the toughest question coming under this topic, reverse syllogism. Got it? You just go through the statements. Statement 1 has some lot of things, you know. Statement 1 states that some A or B, this is one line, and some B or C, second phrase, no C is D, third, and no D is D, fourth. Actually, I have 4 phrases in the single statements. And as I said before, we should always consider single statements, this as a one statement, got it? And I should not take lot of statements for the given. I just have to keep in mind that this is a single statement. And if you have a lot of statements, that's a very small hint, like, how many diagrams I can draw for these 4 statements? If there is 4 phrases given here, and how many minimum possible diagrams I can draw for those diagrams? There is a lot, right? I can draw a lot of diagrams for the given statements. Here we have only 4 statements here. So some A, B and B or C. Here actually I have 1, 2, 3 and 4 and 5. I have 5 objects here. So for 5 objects having connections, I can draw numerous number of diagrams. Got it? I can frame a lot of possibility and I can think of a lot of diagrams. But for this kind of diagrams, there is no need to go for second possibility. And if you are getting the questions like this coming in topic reverse syllogism, you just simply draw only one diagram, that's actually enough for the question. And if there is any confusions for you, you can go and draw a second diagram. Because why I am saying this, like, because the rule of syllogism is like, I should draw at least 2 diagrams, right? But for this topic alone, actually the question being settled in a format that you will draw a lot of diagrams. Lot of diagram for all the statements, not for the given only one statements. Got it? So this question is same, like, I will draw a lot of diagrams because I have a lot of statements here. Got it? So they actually want you to do, like, they actually want you to draw diagrams for given statements. Got it? So again, don't go for any possibility. Check one possibility, that's actually enough for the answer. And go for the first statement, some A or B. So some A or B and some B or C. Some B or C. Again, some A is C. There is possibility one, so I can guess that some A or C, but please don't go for any possibility diagram for reverse syllogism also if you are getting a lot of statements. Got it? I'm just repeating the same point. If you are getting a lot of statements in the same question, this conclusion has only 2 conclusions and statements we actually have 4 statements clubbed under a single statement. Got it? If this is your question, please don't go for any extra possible diagrams. Only one is enough for us. Got it? Again, no C is D, so no C is D, and no D is E. This is my first possible diagram. First possible diagram should be like, there is nothing I can think about this, I am just simply drawing the question as it is, that's it. I am just going to draw the statement as it is and I am not going for any possible diagrams. Got it? And if you are getting a lot of statements, don't go for any possible, only for reverse syllogism. This is not applicable for the normal syllogism. Got it? And please check the conclusions. All D being B is a possibility. So all D being B is a possibility. And here just under the statements, only no C is D. Actually, C and D are not related, but is like, can all D come inside the segment B? Is it possible? Yes, of course it is true. Just it's a possible statement because it's given that being possibility. So possibility means chances, just probability. So I have a chance that all D can come inside B without touching the part C. And second is, some C or E. So some C or E. So is there any connection between C and E? In the given diagram, don't think about the possibility. In the given diagram, is there any relation between the C and E? No. So it is false. Got it? And the statement 1 is getting false. So I can simply put here. So statement 1 is getting true and false. So it is true and false. Now we can go for statement 2. Actually for this question, I have a lot of things. So I just have to keep on writing it. And statement 2 is given like, and again there are 4 things clubbed under a single statement called statement 2. And please always remember, if you are getting more than 2 or 3 statements, don't go for any possibility. One diagram is more than sufficient. And 2 states that all the A or B, all A or B, this is one phrase, and again all B or C, second phrase, and third sentence is some C or D, and fourth sentence is all D or P. Okay, have you drawn up with your diagram? Again, I am having four statements. So as I told before, don't go for any possible diagram. Just draw only one diagram. That's more than sufficient. This is more than enough actually. So my first diagram should be like all A or B. So all A or B, and then all B or again C. So all B or C, and then some C or D. So some C or D, and I can go for the possibility that D can come and say B and A also. That is possible diagrams, but I'm just telling it again, don't go for any possibles if you're getting a lot of statements in this reverse syllogism. And then all D or E. So again all D or E. And please now check the given conclusion. All D being B is a possibility. So all D coming and inside B is a possibility. So can I go for this one? Just again the chances, probability. So can all D come inside B? Of course, yes, it can be. So true. And second is some C or E. So some C or E, it is exactly true here. So both are following. So can I go for statement 2 follow here? 2 is getting followed. So as I told in the previous second question, if it is one thing is getting correct in the first option, I can simply go for yes, statement 2 is getting following. But here the given options are like option A states that 1 and 2 follow, option B states that 2 and 3 follow. Got it? And here the I'm just going to write the given options here. Here the given options, option A states statement 1 and 2 follow. Option B has statement 2 and 3 follow. And C has 3 and 4 follow. And again I have option D as 4 and 5 and E as none follow. So simply, actually 2 is getting followed here. If I have the options like only 2 follow, I can simply go for 2 as a exact answer. But here statements are given like both 1 and 2 getting followed, 2 and 3 getting followed. So I cannot go for B here. So simply please check the third. If third is correct, I can go for this B option. If third statement is getting followed in both the cases, can I go for B option? Of course, yes. Good. And again, statement 3 states that some A or B my first sentence, and my second sentence is all B or C, and third sentence is some C or D. And please, we'll become one more sentence also. And statement 4 states like all D or E. And please draw a diagram. Have you drawn the diagram for the given statements? Again, statement 3 has 4 sentences, and I should draw a single diagram for all the 4 as a first possible diagram. So first possible diagram, some A or B, so some A or B, and then all B or C, so all B or C, again some C or D, some C or D, again all D or E, so again all D or E. Now please check with the conclusion. Conclusion 1 states that all D's being B is a possibility. It's a possibility. So all D coming under B is a possibility. Yes, it is a possibility. Because again, it's chances, so chances can occur. Possibility can occur. And statement conclusion 2, some C or E. So some C or E is exactly following here. So it's actually both getting followed. Statement 2 also getting true and true. 3 also getting true and true. Okay, please now go for the options. So I'm just getting the statement like 2 and 3 is following. So 2 and 3 is following. And I have the options like 2 and 3 follow. So the answer will be B. This is my correct answer. And is it necessary that I should check whether statement 4 and statement 5, is it necessary? Because I have 4 statements also, and I have statement 5 also. I have 5 statements for the same conclusions. So I have checked the 3 one. In the 3, I am getting answer as 2 and 3 is getting followed. So is it necessary to check whether S4 and S5, is it necessary? Absolutely, it is not necessary. So simple. So the answer is go for B, 2 and 3 follow. That is my correct answer. Got my point? Yes. If it is like 1 and 2 follow, 2 and 3 follow, 3 and 4 follow, you simply go for, if it's 2 follow, don't go for option B. Because options here are like 2 and 3 getting followed. So please check it. So if it's 2 and 3 getting followed here, simply go for 3, option B, 2 and 3 follow. And there's no need to waste time in checking the 7, 4, 7, 5. Because ultimately, there's going to be a false option. False conclusion or statements. Got it. So this is like very, very important one. And the first point we actually, I'm actually highlighting here is like simply draw one diagram, that's most enough for this reverse syllogism. In reverse syllogism, if you're getting more than two or three statements, you simply draw one possible diagram, that is enough. The one diagram, that is actually enough for the getting answer. And second possible, second highlighting thing is like, whenever you draw a diagram, always go in the reverse one. Got it? And second thing is like, whenever you check, please simultaneously check with options also. You please simultaneously check with options. Whenever you're getting both follow, whenever you're getting all the sentence getting true, you please check the option. Options can be like, you can even stop in the first step itself, or the second or the third step. Got it? So the first, I'm just elaborating the first segment. So the first important point in reverse syllogism is like, draw only one diagram. That's actually more than enough for it. One diagram for one statement. Got it? Don't go for possible diagram for all the statements if there is a lot of statements. If you have only two statements, for example, if there is only two statements here. Assumption. Got it? If there is only two sentences given statement one, statement three, I can go for some more possible diagrams. Got it? But if there is more than two or more than three statements, draw one diagram that's actually more than enough. My first highlighted point to be taken care of while solving the reverse syllogism. And second important point is like, whenever you draw a diagram and check with options, you please do parallel check with the options also. Whenever you draw a diagram and check with the conclusions, either you will find true or false, right? After finding true or false, please parallelly check with the options also. You may stop in the first point itself. You may stop in statement one itself. Got it? And for some questions, you can try the reverse methodology. You can go solving statement 5 first of all, and then you can solve statement 4, 3, 2, 1. You can go in reverse manner also. That is also a one possible way to find the answer in a very short period of time. Got it? So put it all together. This is the examples I'm just going to solve. Actually solve for the reverse syllogism. Only 3 questions I have solved in reverse syllogism. And if you are coming with any challenging questions, or like if you find some questions, it's very tough, it's very challenging, you can please leave a comment below the particular questions or the particular link of the questions, and we may do a elaborated sessions on the particular questions also. Got it? And this question, I'm just going to summarize the important point in reverse syllogism. Reverse syllogism is nothing but a very important topic. In these days, they actually asking this type of questions. You know, they simply asking the syllogism in a reverse manner. That is called as reverse syllogism. And instead of statement here, I'll have conclusions. Again, vice versa. Instead of C, I'll have S here. Conclusion instead of statements. Got it? So it's just simply, again, the very important point is always draw diagram only for statements and drawing for conclusions. It's actually a very wrong method. Got it? Whatever the topic may be, reverse syllogism or normal syllogism, always draw diagram only for the conclusion statements, not for the conclusions. Simple. Again check with the diagram if it's correct. So true, if it's wrong, it is false. Again, the same thing, the same manner. And if you're getting more than two or three sentences in the same statements, you simply draw one diagram that's actually more than enough for the question. Simple.